Hello, fellow human! Welcome back to another Dank Door / Choosing Beggars. We have 7 stories in total for you guys today. The first story is posted by you/FancyBeast13 with the title of Freeload Off My Wi-Fi, Get Snipped! Wanted to join in on the Wi-Fi fun? This is my Choosing Beggars story. This was about 12 years ago, 13 years old at the time, and me and a couple of my neighbored friends would play Halo 3 online. My next neighbor, who at the time didn't have internet connection, felt left out, and me, being the good friend I am, offered him my Wi-Fi password so he could join in. A week passes, and he complains the internet is slow, as he lives on the 4th floor of his apartment, and I live on the 2-floor home. He then asked me to ask my parents to upgrade our plan so he can get faster speeds. I laughed and said no! Fast forward a week, and me and my 5 other neighbor friends are in Xbox Live party, including CB. And one of my other friends mentions that it was nice that I let CB run a 100 feet Ethernet cable to my router. I'm confused, as CB is telling him to shut up and go upstairs to check. The router was in my brother's room next to the window. This mother ducker bought a 100 feet cable to run from his room in the attic to my brother's upstairs room. He did this while I was away and told my parents I'd let him do this. So at this point I'm furious and all my friends are laughing, including CB. So as he's laughing, I grab a pair of scissors and snip his cable and throw it in his backyard and change my Wi-Fi password. He didn't play with us for 2 months until he finally convinced his parents to get internet. The torture of him listening about all of our online fun when we hung out was payback enough for me. But still, the real question is, why the hell did the parents let the beggar just did that? Came into their home and wearing some 100 feet physical cables? Did they even care? On to the second story, written by you/EdenByArgue1988. Man returns iPhone, owner complains. This isn't my story, but one I heard on the radio. There's this radio show where I'm from, where a lawyer does this call-ins from people asking him to help arbitrate their cases. My country doesn't really have a small claims court, and most people are too poor to afford a lawyer anyway. One case involved a man who forgot his iPhone, whatever was new in 2016, in a taxi. Normally, that would mean that the iPhone was lost forever, because pawning a brand new iPhone could make you more than a month's salary. But the taxi driver was a decent person and found a way to return the phone. So why was the guy who against all odds got his then brand new iPhone back calling a lawyer? Because it wasn't returned sooner! Yes, the guy who forgot his iPhone and got it returned to him called a lawyer and tried to publicly shame the person who returned an iPhone. An iPhone that, I would like to remind you, probably cost more than he made in a month. Because it got returned to him the Monday after he had lost it, he lost it on a Friday. He claims that he needed it for work and that it contains a lot of his personal information, but nobody believed him. The lawyer tore into him on live radio and he basically got shouted down for being entitled jackass. Well, it's always nice to call out entitled people because if you don't, they will never realize what's the flaw in their way of thinking. On to the third story, shared by you/YataGarasu513. Don't you dare eat while you teach me for free! So guys, reading all these stories reminded me of a moment in my life that, looking back, just seems entitled as heck. I have 2 aunts on my mother's side of the family. My mother kept up contact with them when she moved to England, and after some difficult battles with immigration agency, finally managed to bring them to stay in England with us as well. One of them is lovely, but the other, well, I could probably write a book about the crazy things she did after moving in with us. Eventually, both my nice aunt, Anne, and the crazy aunt, CA, move out. Mostly because my mother finally loses patience with CA just making life difficult for us all, and Anne felt obliged to stick with her, since my mother was pretty firmly situated. Now, for the CB part. I'm at university and I have a job teaching English on weekends to make some extra money. Anne calls me on one weekend and asks about some English lessons as her and CA are having trouble with theirs and it's getting in their way. I agree, and since their house is en route for my university to work, I arranged to stop by after work for 2 hours per one session each Saturday and Sunday. NA offers to pay, but I refuse. So the first session rolls around, CA barely says a word, but NA makes good progress. NA offers to pay again, but I refuse, at which point she offers to make me dinner. I've not eaten much that day, so I agree, and she does. CA shoots her a bit of dirty look, but I brush it off. This turns into a routine for a few weeks. I'd go tutor them for a couple of hours, after which I would eat dinner with them. Then one day, out of the blue, I get a call from NA that goes something like this. NA, hi, is everything okay? Thank you for the lessons. They have been really helpful. Me, sure, everything is fine. You? You've gone so much better. Is next weekend still okay? NA, well, that was why I called. CA doesn't like you taking our food. Me, what? NA, she says you're coming to teach, not to eat with us, and if you want to eat, you can bring your own food. I, at this point, ask her to hand the phone over to CA. Me, okay, I don't see what the problem is. Is what NA saying true?
CA, I don't like you eating our food for free. We have to buy that. If you come to our house to teach, that's all you should do.
Me, taken aback. Well, okay. I can eat before I arrive, but it will mean I can only teach for an hour and a half or so.
CA, no! You need to teach for the same time as you do now. Just leave your job a bit earlier if you need to eat.
Me, just speechless. Yeah, no. I hung up and ended up just cutting CA out from there on out. I'm sorry, but I'm not losing time at the job that's helping me to get through university for someone who feels her sister offering to make me dinner is too demanding of me. Sorry for the length of the post, but it was really irritating memory I thought I would share. I would like to clarify some of the points being made. This happened in autumn of 2015, when I was in my last year of university. My families are all Indians and I'm the only nephew my aunts have, so NA has always doted on me. Also, I did make an effort to keep helping NA with her English, but rather than pop by every weekend, we decided to use Skype after I would return home from work. She's always been grateful for my help, and I used to see her regularly. She was actually recruited as a nurse just before I moved away, which I know she was always interested in. As for CA, well, I haven't heard from her since that phone call. Seriously, offering food is the least a person can do to thank someone for helping them for free. Some people are just too cheap, man, to live in this world. On to the fourth story, shared by you/found dumbed. Landlord gives me away my bed, ask me to leave it disassembled and ready to go. This happened in 2012, and it was a real life conversation, so sadly, I haven't got photographic proof. I was about to move out of an apartment, and I asked the landlord if it was alright if I left the bed behind. The bed was mine, but the new place already had a bed, and the old bed was a pain in the butt to take apart, because it was one of those high beds where you can have desk underneath. The landlord said yes, and so I can proceed to plan the move without worrying about the bed. Then, just a few days shy of my moving out, the landlord tells me I, of course, would have to take the bed apart and get it out of the room. I chortled and said, in that case, I might as well sell it because the only reason I wasn't selling it was to avoid taking it apart. Then, check this out, my landlord tells me I couldn't sell it because his wife has told a friend they could have it. I laughed in his face and sold the ducking bed. Some nerve. Well, I think it is a universal truth that people are willing to do work they wouldn't normally willing to do if doing such work out of spite will make someone who is being a jerk angry. On to the fifth story shared by you/jman464. Customer claims we ruined her son's Christmas because she thought her car would grow. This happened almost 2 years ago, so go easy on me. I work retail at a large sporting goods store around the holidays. My store had a large trampoline for sale, of which a customer bought, but quickly found out it was too large to fit in her sedan. No problem. We told her we would put it on hold for her and she would come back when she found a car to borrow or someone to help her out. This was in early December and it was common practice for us to put items in the back with a tag saying it's for ex-customer and that she had already paid. Fast forward to a few weeks later, Christmas Eve around 5:30. Store closes at 6, same customer calls and asks if she can come and get her trampoline, but she will be late. Fine, we'll be there anyways, closing down. I go to the backstock area, only to find someone has sold her trampoline. No big deal, another store is 15 minutes away with one in stock. I hop in my personal truck, drive to the other store, pick up the trampoline and head back to the store. I arrive at roughly at the same time as the customer. We tell her we can just move it straight from the bed of my truck to her car. Sounds good! Wrong! We go outside to find she is in the same car she came before to the store in weeks ago and has her son in the car. Presumably the one who is receiving the trampoline for Christmas. Again, we tell her that this trampoline will not fit in the car. At this point, she is irritated that the trampoline is not wrapped for her. Not a service that we have ever offered or advertised that it won't fit, and now that we have now ruined Christmas for her son, because he knows he's getting a trampoline now and he won't have it tomorrow morning. At this time, my store director graciously offers to put the trampoline in his car and drive it to this woman's house that is fairly close by. We don't offer delivery, by the way. She agrees! And now the rest of the store is now secondhand, due to me no longer being there and was told to me by the director at my next shift. So the director drives to her house with this trampoline on Christmas Eve instead of being with his family. He arrives to which this woman goes inside and shuts the door without offering any instructions or help to my director. He proceeds to stand at the door for a knock for an extended period of time before she opens the door as if she is bothered that he's there. He tells her that he's going to just put the trampoline outside of the garage, which infuriates her because it's not under the tree. He obliges and by himself get this trampoline up to her front porch stairs and to the door, which he didn't discover is closed and locked again. He again waits on her to open the door, to which she never does. At this point, he decides that enough has been done to appease this customer and goes on his way to enjoy Christmas Eve with his family. Now, fast forward to the day after Christmas, the next day the store was open and who comes marching in? This lady, and she is furious. The director takes her into his office and she proceeds to scream and throw a fit demanding a refund because we ruined Christmas for a kid because we were so unaccommodating to her. Apparently she was mad that he didn't put it under the tree for her. My store director quickly shuts this down, explains what happened, why he left it, where he did, and everything we did to make sure she got this trampoline. She's not having any of this, and at this time, she is asked to leave the store because of her screaming. She refuses. PD is quickly called, and she is escorted out of the building, and as far as I know, never seen again at the store. Damn, what a shameless and ungrateful woman! On to the sixth story shared by you/killornot. Call the cops over $9. When I was in high school, I worked at a restaurant. At the restaurant, if you ordered a dinner, you normally got a free salad bar. And at our establishment, this also included vegetables on the hot bar. One night, a couple came in late and ordered drinks and steak dinners, well done. I explained that the salad bar was at their disposal and bought out their drinks. They were both rude to me, but I was used to this behavior at the time. When you serve tables, getting treated like crap just comes with a job. They had two plates each off the bar by the time their steaks came out. Keep in mind that this was late at night and they were the only ones there. They didn't have to wait very long for the dinners. As soon as I put the steaks down, the wife cuts in with her steak knife and said the steaks were too tough. I asked if they wanted the kitchen to recook them, but they said no, they just want to cancel the order. I took the plates back to the kitchen and told the manager, who proceeds to pull apart the steak with her hands. It wasn't tough at all. Customer did this sometimes. Our district manager was notorious for giving the free stuff away. Most customers would run you to death. And then when they got up to the registers, they would demand discounts. As was our policy, I changed the ticket to charge them for only salad bars and remove the steaks. When I brought the check to the table, they said no, we aren't paying anything tonight. I explained the policy and said since you ate off the salad bar, I have to charge you for it. They made the biggest ruckus ever over that check. It was only $8 or $9, but they acted like we were doing them so wrong. Everyone on staff was upset. The restaurant was empty, and we were all there after close dealing with these people. The manager tried to explain it to them, but they said they were not paying and that was final. The manager was done. She said if they left without paying, she would call the police. They left. The manager told me to follow them out and get their license plate number. I made a busboy to go out with me because I was only 17 and scared of everyone. The manager called the police. The juicing beggars heard the manager and walked past their car in a lot. I guess they were just going to leave it behind and come back later. But here's the thing. We're in a small town and I guess the police didn't have a lot going on. Because I had only stepped a few steps into the parking lot when three cops pulled in and surrounded them. It was like a scene out of a movie and I'm so happy I got to witness it. They marched the CBs right back in and made them pay their bill. The whole time the wife was crying and says, "Call the cops over $9, who does that?" And the manager stood there smug and they said they were not welcome back. It was a pretty good night. These beggars got some serious issues, man. Like, who the hell would throw a tantrum over paying $9 for a meal? I bet they didn't even want the steaks in the first place, just a free salad. On to the final story shared by you/city psychologist. Lady asked for free bottles and gets annoyed when I offered her the wrong one. I used to work in a bar and one day a lady, CB, comes in. She says she worked at the theater and was looking for props for her play. She asked if we had any empty liquor bottles we were going to throw away. I did, and I'm nice, so I said yes. I went to grab some gin and vodka bottles from the recycling bin. CB: "Oh, I was hoping to get something like Johnny Walker bottle." Me: "Oh, sorry, we don't have that one." CB: "Yes, you do, it's right there." Points at full bottle on shelf. Me: "Ma'am, it's still full. That's why it's on the shelf, not the bin." CB: "Just pour it out. I don't want the other ones." Me: "Confused." CB: "Fine, I'll just go somewhere else. Thanks for nothing." And then she storms out like I just lost a customer. Like, okay? Woman, you weren't even paying. I mean, OP should have quoted her the price of the entire bottles in shots. $8 billion. And as a side note, she probably just wanted a nice empty bottle to pour some cheap stuff into so their friends are impressed. Kids do this all the time. That's it for today, fellow humans. Thanks for watching. DankDoggo appreciates your time. If you enjoy our content and want to see more of us, stay tuned and subscribe. Don't forget to smash that like button and ring the bell or Doggo will cry. Also, you can always tell us your friendly neighbor Doggo your experiences in the comment section. I'll catch up with you guys later in the next video.